I feel like the world that these creatures inhabit, it's meant to be kind of an unconscious terrain, that it's suggestive for me of a dream state, so it's almost illustrating my own dream state. Most of the images are some kind of dialogue with myself, either examining fixation on past negative events. Even though a number of the works still focus on negative topics, it's not in the same way that I have in the past, where I think oftentimes in the past I was wallowing in negativity. And actually, one of these pieces is even called Wallow, and it's dealing with the idea of how we can be haunted by our own ghosts. Like in Japan, there's the idea of yurei, which are these ghosts which wind up getting trapped between worlds because they have some kind of unresolved issues. As a metaphor, that's what we all do to some degree. We get locked into some past event or experience we've had, and we kind of can't let go of it. And so it kind of is this constant phantom ghost that follows you. And until you shake it off, you can't move forward. So in a way, the work was almost about trying to shake off ghosts. I think a lot of us fall prey to this, but you can fall prey to the influence of others if you're not really staying centered and regulating your own life. And I think that I was trying to explore the idea of the fox character kind of as a false prophet that is leading these individuals towards some promise, whatever it is. On the other panel of that diptych, we see that, you know, the fox is leading them towards a bunch of tusks, like basically an elephant graveyard. The sheep in that figure is just meant to be oblivious, so it's too locked into satisfying its own needs to really even notice what's going on. And then in the opposing panel, there's this bird that has basically this Buddhist mask on its face, and it's basically ignoring the deception and facing in the opposite direction, going the other way. When I get ready to start a body of work, I never would have enough room to get all the work on the walls, but I like to get as much as I can up selectively so that then when I lay my palettes down, I can instantly start just harvesting off the walls and putting it down on the work. And it speeds everything up a lot so that I can really be more in an immediate space, because if I don't have that immediacy, I lose momentum on the work. So on some level, it was actually more an act of therapy than anything else, the new body of work.